If you don't do any programming in R, you might think that it takes something like this to produce something like this. Not so. Instead, I can use lines of code like this. I'll let you look at this for a few seconds. For those of you familiar with the Leaflet JavaScript library, you might know where this is heading, to make a visualization like this. A map of Starbucks in Atlanta from a geocoded data file available for download at Socrata's open data site. You can click and zoom this map, and you could do the same thing with a starting point anywhere and a broader zoom level. Now let's take a look at the code. This first line takes a CSV file and reads it into an R variable that I've called Starbucks. I'm using the built-in R function read.csv. If you haven't downloaded the data yet, you can download it directly from the URL. The second line loads the R leaflet package. This assumes I already installed the package on my system. If not, I'd run one other line of code to install it. This line creates a new blank leaflet map with basic map tiles. Line 4 tells the map to start off at the lat and long I've entered, which is Atlanta. I also set a zoom level to be fairly local. And this final line uses the addMarkers function to add markers. Data for the markers comes from my Starbucks variable I created in line 1. We're also telling it which columns have lat and long info, and that if you click a marker, you should get a pop-up with the location's name. Next up, let's look at Anthem stock prices before and after news of a big customer data breach, so say in the last 6 months. Here's your code. 3 lines. That's it. You don't have to even find and load the data yourself. Just load the quantmod package, pull data for the stock symbol ANTM, and generate the chart. Done. Quantmod also pulls in data from the St. Louis Federal Reserve. I looked up their symbol for Atlanta area unemployment, so I can fetch that data with one line of code. This creates an R time series object with two columns, dates and data. I'll use a brand new R package that hooks into the digraphs JavaScript library. Now I can graph that data with one line of code. It's a JavaScript graph, so you can roll your cursor over to see the data points. You can also click and drag to zoom in. If that ATLA013 URN bugs you as a column name, you can change it with this line of code. Next up, we've got a CSV file with school, district, score, number of students, and percent students who come from poor families. Question, is there a correlation between poverty rates and test results? Here, I'll load the test data and the ggviz library, create a basic plot object to look at percent poor by scores, and create two interactive sliders, one for point size and one for opacity. The last line adds a linear model, a line that best shows any trend or direction of all the points. And in 5 lines of code, I get an interactive scatter plot with 2 sliders where I can control point size and opacity. For correlation coefficients among all the factors, that's one line of code. The na.omit removes rows with missing data, and myData3:6 says I just want columns 3 through 6 because those have the numbers. But a visualization is so much nicer. Here's the code. Load the library, set the color palette, generate the correlation plot. There you have it, 5 data visualizations in R in 5 lines of code or less. I'm Sharon Maclis with Computer World.